Patrick, thank you for calling me on New Jersey 101.5. It's good to have you on the air.
Hey, how you doing, Bill?
Good. So, your polls have been very accurate over the past few years. You've been very good with not only statewide races, but the Monmouth University polling has been at the top of the charts. And as I understand, it's been included in some of the debate criteria.
Right.
So now you've got a new poll out where Ted Cruz has overtaken Donald Trump in Iowa. Tell me about it. What do you think happened?
Yeah, well, basically, Donald Trump's support has been very stable.
Yeah.
And so it hasn't moved over the past few months, a few points up or down. But Ted Cruz is picking up a lot of steam, and it's mainly because Ben Carson is fading away very fast.
So he's grabbing the evangelical votes.
Yeah, it's a big evangelical vote, particularly out in Iowa, where it's about a majority of those Republican voters will be evangelicals. So they've just all swung over to Ted Cruz. Ted Cruz has always been hawkish, so as terrorism has increased as an issue of concern for Republicans, that is another plus in his corner. Right. He also got a big endorsement out in Iowa from influential Congressman Steve King. So there, he put all these pieces together, and that explains Ted Cruz's rise in Iowa, as well as he's doing well better nationally, too, but Iowa is the place where he's got the best shot.
So is it, let me tell you, I mean, you're a professional, you've been doing this for a long time. Is it too early to put any stock in the polling now? And I'm not saying your polling's not accurate for where people stand today, because it clearly it's reflecting something, but is it too early?
It is too early. I mean, look, we ask a question, which after everybody tells us who they're going to vote for, we say, okay, is there a possibility that you're going to change your mind? And only 19% of these Republican voters that we talked to over the weekend said, I'm absolutely locked in.
Okay.
So, yes, there is absolutely.
Now, that's a great number. So, 1 in 5 are locked in, 4 in 5 up for grabs. In the little remaining time I've got, Patrick, what about Governor Christie? He seems to be doing very well in New Hampshire, not so much in Iowa. What do you see as his prospects? He's going to be on Ask the Governor tonight with Eric Scott. And I'm just leading into that. Where do you see his prospects going? And, does this help him?
There's room for him in Iowa. It just doesn't. I mean, he's improved his favorability ratings out there, but it's just not. It's a different type of electorate. But in New Hampshire, I polled there last month, and I saw his favorabilities turn around, and that's the first step. And now we've seen a number of other polls. He's gotten some great endorsements. Mm-hmm. New Hampshire is going to be his state. That's his make or break it state.
Can he win?
He can win New Hampshire, at least come in the top three, which gets his ticket punched to some of the next states. The question is, who does he go up against in those southern states which command all the attention on Super Tuesday? That'll be the big question.
Are you going to poll right after the debate next week?
No, we're not going to do it after the debate. We're going to wait until January to go back out into the field.
Yeah. All right, good. Well, I'd love to talk to you. You know, we'll talk to you over the next couple of weeks as this develops. Patrick Murray, Monmouth University pollster, thank you for joining me on New Jersey 101.5.